Hello students, welcome to NRS Education Channel. Let us continue the lesson T from Assam. In our previous session, we came to know Rajveer. He told two legends regarding who started drinking tea first. Now, let us continue the lesson. Tea was first drunk in China, Rajveer added, as far back as 2700 BC. In fact, words such as tea, chai and chini are from Chinese. Tea came to Europe only in the 16th century and was drunk more as medicine than beverage. Tea was first drunk in China, Rajveer added, as far back as 2700 BC. Okay, 2700 BC. That time only Chinese were drinking tea. Okay. In fact, words such as chai and chini are from Chinese. Words like chai and chini. They are Chinese language words. Tea came to Europe only in 16th century and was drunk more as medicine than as beverage. Okay, tea came to Europe only in the 16th century and it was drunk more as medicine than beverage. Okay, they were not drinking it as beverage. Okay, beverage means the liquid which we drink for refreshment. Okay, it was not drunk as beverage, instead it was drunk as medicine. Okay, as a medicine Europeans used to drink tea. The train clattered into Mariani Junction. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to crowded platform. Yes, then train stopped in Mariani Junction, in which they have to get down. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform. They started to move in the crowded platform. Pranjal's parents were waiting for them. Already Pranjal's parents came there and they were waiting for these boys. Soon they were driving towards Dekibari, the tea garden managed by Pranjal's father. Then they started to move in a car towards Dekibari, the tea garden, okay, which was managed by Pranjal's father. An hour later, the car veered sharply off the main road. They crossed Cattle Bridge and entered Dekibari Tea Estate. Yes, an hour later, car veered, veered means moved sharply off the main road. From the main road, it moved to the another road. They crossed a cattle bridge. Cattle bridge you might have seen if there is a ditch downside, upside by using the iron bars. In some bridge will be made. That is called what? Cattle bridge. Probably you might have seen in front of hospitals or in front of schools also. In some schools also you can see such kind of cattle bridge. Enter the Dekibari Tea Estate. Then their car entered the Dekibari Tea Estate. On the both sides of gravel road were acre upon acre of tea bushes. While their car was moving both the side, there were acres upon acre of tea bushes. All neatly pruned to the same height. All the tea plants were pruned. Pruned means cut or trimmed or shaped. Okay. They were all shaped into the same height. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. Okay, group of tea pluckers with bamboo basket, okay, on their backs, wearing plastic aprons. They were wearing plastic aprons. Aprons means overdress. Okay, aprons were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. They were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. Pranjal's father slowed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of tea leaves to pass. Yes, then Pranjal's father slowed down the car because he wanted to give way to the tractor which was coming in front of him. That tractor was pulling a trailer load of tea leaves. Okay, in order to give way, Pranjal's father slowed down the car. This is the second flush or sprouting period, isn't it, Mr. Barua? Rajveer asked. It lasts from May to July and yields the best tea. Then Rajveer asked to Mr. Barua. Mr. Barua is Pranjal's father. Okay. This is the second flush or sprouting period. I think it is second period. Okay, second season. Isn't it second period for plucking the tea leaves? Okay. Period. Isn't it, Mr. Barua? He asked to Barua. Rajveer asked. It lasts from May to July and yields the best tea. Okay. This second season, it starts in the month of May and it continues up to the month of July, and it yields, it means give out, okay, the best tea, isn't it? Like that he asked to Mr. Barua. See here, Rajveer, though he born and brought up in Delhi, he studied many things about Assam, particularly about tea plants and their seasons. Okay, see that. These tea seasons, tea plucking seasons, there are two main seasons. One is from March to mid-October. You can say that one. That is the first season. Second season, as it is mentioned in the lesson, May to July. Okay, so that was the second season time. You seem to have done your homework before coming, Pranjal's father said in surprise. I think you seem to have done your homework before coming. I think you have studied many things about tea before you coming to this place, Pranjal's father said in surprise. Yes, Mr. Barua, Rajveer admitted. But I hope to learn much more while I am here. Yes, I have studied many things about tea, but still I hope to learn much more while I am here. Until I will stay here, I want to learn many things about tea. I want to learn more things about tea. Like that, Rajveer said to Mr. Barua. So, with this we can understand the life of Assam people, particularly the importance of tea in Assam. Okay. So, in this lesson, about three different places and their specialities we have seen. Glimpses of India lesson, in that three parts were there. The baker, a baker from Goa, in that we have seen about the importance of bakers in Goa society, and second one was Coorg, the importance of Coorg we have seen, and third one tea from Assam. With this, we have completed this lesson. Thank you for watching.